And the big political story breaking in India this hour is that the Election Commission of India is expected to announce dates for elections to the key states of Gujarat and Himachal Pradesh later today. The elections are likely to be held in Gujarat in December as new assembly has to be in place in January. This will be the first election in the state after Narendra Modi left to take over as Prime Minister. Gujarat is the home state of Prime Minister Narendra Modi. And this is one state which people say that Prime Minister Modi cannot afford to lose if he wants to retain momentum. And on this issue, I'm joined by my senior correspondent, Raghvendra Rao, who will be joining us very shortly. Raghvendra, my question to you is, how significant the elections of both Himachal Pradesh and Gujarat are for the national narrative in India?
Well, Kartike, Himachal, as we have known, it always votes the incumbent government out of power. That has been the trend there. But this time around, the BJP is hoping to ride on Prime Minister Narendra Modi's charisma. And, the fact that if one were to go by the historical facts, BJP would feel that it is, in line to form the next government in Himachal Pradesh. The Veerbhadra Singh-led Congress government could be on its way out. But the fact that the Congress too is digging its heels in Himachal Pradesh will make it a very interesting fight. Now, Gujarat is Prime Minister Narendra Modi's own bastion, his own state. He has been the chief minister of Gujarat for multiple terms. And it is more of a prestige battle. Now, whether the Congress really manages to put up a fight in Gujarat or not, that remains to be seen. Congress Vice President Rahul Gandhi has been trying to make inroads into Gujarat. But all said and done, the fact that these two states, Gujarat in particular, just because the Prime Minister of India happens to hail from that state, that would be the mother of all battles.
Raghvendra, in case, there are results which are unexpected, do you think they'll have a stronger impact when it comes to national politics?
Well, absolutely. And, the fact that state assembly elections always have some degree of impact on the national politics, one can always distinguish between national issues and state issues. Usually, we have found that parties who have done well nationally could have, even faltered at the state level because the issues are different. But in this particular case, the fact that Gujarat is a very important state, it's a prestige battle of sorts for the Prime Minister. And it's almost a referendum on, how the Modi government has been running the country at the center. And the fact that BJP has been in such a powerful position in Gujarat, it really would be a very interesting scenario to see whether the opposition parties can muster up any kind of resistance to the BJP juggernaut. I mean, the BJP electoral juggernaut has been rolling ever since Prime Minister Narendra Modi was, he assumed office in the center. But for a few setbacks, be it in Delhi or Bihar, it is the BJP which has been winning election after election. And that essentially has much to do with Prime Minister Modi's charisma and the way the central government has been conveying it to the state government that things have actually changed ever since the BJP government assumed charge at the center. So in that sense, whatever happens in Gujarat, whatever happens in Himachal, it will have a bearing on national politics. It will have a bearing on central politics. People will correlate. I mean, if BJP were to win, say, in Gujarat and Himachal, obviously it will be considered as a stamp of approval on Narendra Modi's policies, things like demonetization, GST over things which the central government has been facing a lot of flak, the economic slowdown. But if BJP were to win these states, it would be a stamp of approval of sorts. If it were to lose in these states, then it would also be construed as the central government's failure in many aspects. And that is why both these elections are very keenly contested, and they'll be fun to watch out for.
Thank you, Raghvendra, for this input.